श्री सर पांडे जी और सर यार भट्ट सर
दिस इज फॉर्म ऑफ
चेयर ऑफ दिस सेशन द चेयरमैन ऑफ आई सी यार सर आज से ना सर प्रवेश कर सर एंड ऑफ द लंडन ऑडियंस इसलिए माय पेपर इज नॉट कंप्लीट इट इज इन द स्टेज ऑफ वर्किंग सो आई वुड नॉट सबमिट इट फॉर सबमिशन बट आई वुड लाइक I was planning to request Mr. Bhatt sir to comment unofficially, but it is unfortunate that Mr. Bhatt is to chair the session, so automatically, naturally, I will have the grace of Mr. Bhatt sir. And in regard to his suggestion and comment, I would supplement some matter to my paper and ultimately I'll submit to My paper is Wittgenstein and Buddhism and Transcendence. I think better to read my paper than to discuss whatever I can do. The Buddhist practice of avoiding conceptual descriptions of experience of enlightenment was compared to Wittgenstein's declaration in the Spectator's Logical Philosophers that what we cannot speak about, we must pass over in silence. Wittgenstein's later idea of private games expressed in philosopher instigations was examined in terms of potential used in the exploration of transcendental experiences, with a focus upon the ability and variability of such language games. Mythological issues involving the conceptual nature of transcendence and its manifestation are also considerable in this context. Jain Buddhism, I have taken Jain Buddhism particularly. During my study, I found that specifically Jain Buddhism discussed had a view upon the transcendent in their practices. But I am not fully aware of the Jain Buddhism. In order to teach classes, we have the general knowledge of Buddhism, but not a particular specific knowledge of But I have compared with Wittgenstein. Jain Buddhism, Wittgenstein's language game are specific sources of transcendence. Within the Jain tradition of Buddhism, master or guru primarily understands the nature of enlightenment of transcendence and can recognize its presence in another person. The master knows when the aspirant knows. Within the Jain tradition of Buddhism, after discussion, the master seems to know whether the aspirant is on the path of self-realization. Although the terms enlightenment and self-realization are sometimes used synonymously, yet enlightenment seems to be associated with the earlier stage of self-realization. While self-realization is often considered to be a deeper awakening, however, the ultimate In advocacy of conceptual expression of enlightenment and self-realization is to be acknowledged here. Throughout his life, following a Catholic background, Wittgenstein was favorably predisposed towards mysticism, that is, the doctrine of his creed maintaining that one can gain knowledge of reality that is not susceptible to sense perception or to rational conceptual thought. His later interest in the aesthetics of music and other arts confirmed the difficulties Wittgenstein had anticipated in the Tractatus concerning the inability of language to eliminate transcendent experience, whether it is mystical, ethical, or aesthetic experience. Wittgenstein's final line in the Tractatus had already been a major part of Buddhist practice for centuries. However, the acceptance of some limited value associated with linguistic explanation of mystical, ethical, and aesthetic experiences has been suggested by scholars such as Zernick and Tormin and Lundquist. The inability of language as means of apprehending the meaning of transcendent experiences has been implied by Buddhist practice for centuries. Buddhism and Wittgenstein in the Tractatus emphasized the non-conceptual understanding of the actuality of mystical experience and other transcendental phenomena. Buddhist allows some world-based quantum computers have yet the enlightenment lies beyond conceptual thinking. The detectors of whom created the initial impression that what can be said are only positions of natural science. But this time, what now to form it from a positivist point of view? As some philosophers may have thought, his point was that there are realms of human experience such as mysticism, ethics, aesthetic, which sometimes are beyond language. Despite Wittgenstein's early view, expressed in the Tractatus was continued to be routinely used in the attempt to understand transcendent experiences. Janneke told me, the writers, famous writers, suggest that to some extent language can facilitate at least an approach to transcendent experience despite our shortcomings by helping us to see that we need to understand beyond words. Well, the impact of the distinction between saying and showing, acknowledged by Wittgenstein, led to increased awareness among philosophers that aspects of human experience are beyond propositional language. Wittgenstein aborted mystical references have been compared to Jain practices of acting with an empty mind. Actually, I have not dealt in detail with Jain Buddhism, but as far as I understand, during my study, and in order to compare the Buddhism with Wittgenstein, there are some stages of enlightenment. Some writers on Jain Buddhism, like Kalpya or another some, they have mentioned some stages of enlightenment, which let me speak here. That the evidence of enlightenment, evidence of great enlightenment, these are the stages of enlightenment. Evidence of deepened enlightenment, evidence of direct experience of the great way of this evidence of attaining the non regressing mind, evidence of the joy and peace of being at one with the Dharma, and further evidence of the joy, peace of being at one with Dharma and the presentation of death. Hence, during Jain Buddhism, I think, support that the highest level, the level which he has described, the highest level is the stage of transcendence. So, this is the brief comparison that the practice of avoiding the conceptual description by Jain Buddhism is to be compared with the Wittgenstein's view that whatever can accept, it can pass over silently, which he has quoted in Tractatus. So, thus, the difficulties of finding language games for transcendence are perceived here. The job they are supposed to do relies upon the choice of which words qualify for language game. But the games can also be widely spread and different, even though they may have a family resemblance. The environment to looking at transcendence, conceptualized in terms of Buddhist practice. Whatever definition is the starting point should express some aspects of an related state. However, this is a very minimal description of an experience that can lead to enlightenment. However, transcendence in the form of a breakthrough in understanding may be relatively simple, while other experiences of transcendence may be elevated and beyond words. If you look for words that appear to have some frequency of use in being associated with transcendence, this question arises naturally, question how can we know whether these words were associated with the genuine experience of transcendence. The root of the problem lies actually in the validity of whatever at time information describes in experience. One person's experience of transcendence may be more like a dream state put by the contemplation of nature on a sunny day rather than transcendence. And again, a problem arises to how can we look for appropriate word games when we have such limited and variable information on the nature of transcendence. Transcendence actually seems to depend more on those Buddhists who have had conceptual language in describing the experience. Had transcendent experience and realized the futurity आप अटेम्प्ट टू यूज डिस्क्राइबिंग कंसेप्चुअल लैंग्वेज टू डिस्क्राइबिंग द एक्सपीरियंस पोएट्री मेटाफिजिकल लैंग्वेज एंड इमोटिव एक्सप्रेशंस सीम टू अकर इन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केसेस द एक्सपीरियंस मे क्रिएट अ सेंस ऑफ वंडर एंड अ चांस इन वर्ल्ड व्यू बट दीज मेटाफिजिकल्स आर नॉट स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड द लेटर पीरियड ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग स्पेक्टेटर सीम टू बी मोर कंफर्टेबल with a sense of ineffability that is often referenced in discussion of advanced transcendence. As far as focus upon ordered language, Krishna and Kala acknowledge that there are indeed things that cannot be put into words. They make themselves manifest. They are what is mystical. The tetrasa as a whole was just as ultimately leading to philosophical nonsense. Acknowledge this statement in the text. However, the so-called mystical part of the text has been well received, particularly by scholars of religion. Research that attempts to openly and directly explore the presence of transcendence can be difficult because the phenomenon is unusual. Buddhism, discussed earlier in this article in my paper, discourages conceptually based accounts of transcendence. Difference of transcendence appears to attack what seems to characterize many honest examples of transcendence. The variability of the context in which the phenomenon may occur resembles the kind of diversity expressed in Einstein's language games. The situations could share a family resemblance in some respect as well as significant contextual diversity. The invisible nature of an individual's transcendence is not well served by language alone. However, the body is a variable source of expressing the experience or showing meaning by a particular art path. Description of transcendence seems somewhat limited to an invasion of consciousness within a positively perceived experience. Traditionally, it appears in part to be associated with being an aspirant of religious or spiritual way of life. The fact that transcendence appears to be a disjunctive concept means that it can be defined in many ways and in different settings. Lists of attributes or behaviors are not always constant. The context in which transcendence occurs may or may not be significant. Transcendence can be, this is my last one, transcendence can be associated with religion, personal growth, higher level of consciousness, being endowed in sports and in so-called spiritual experience, not associated with the family of religion. Religions. The transcendence can also be involved in going beyond usual limits of pain and fatigue in athletic performance, for example. Psychological investigation of this experience of participants in dangerous sport, for example, have opened a new frontier in the study of transcendence. These examples are merely some of the many contexts in which transcendence may occur. The nature of the transcendence varies to some extent in its response to the context in which it occurs. The variability of contexts and their associated aims may at least share the experience of going beyond their usual experience to a higher level of consciousness related to the purpose of the professor group. Thank you very much. I think I would have spent 20 minutes not more than this. It is all but it is not complete. I have already expressed any inability or incomplete my paper. But this is now open up to you to add, to comment, to suggest, and particularly to our chairperson, Mr. Bhatt Prasad. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, the main points he has tried to capture is clear to you. He would not like to use the word, conceptualizing. There is no possibility of capturing the concept of transcendence in language. But it is experiential, like the example of you know, Jain Buddhists, the Buddhists who believe in liberation and also believe in spiritual elevation of our ordinary consciousness. And that spiritual elevation or the journey need not have to be along with the ordinary language. You may not be able to describe every stage in your consciousness development or growth, you know, in the ordinary language. So the language that you use, at the best will be some, as Wittgenstein has said, analogical or metaphorical. You are trying to say something which is impossible for you to express yet, like a dumb fellow trying to express in sign language, you know, something of that kind. You are the person who has not achieved spiritual liberation, might be trying to suggest and so on, and that is the way it should be taken. So the journey is that of spiritual journey, and most often religious people really undertake this kind of, you know, especially in Buddhism, Jainism and other Indian schools, you will find that they are religious too. So, variety you will find. The language they use, the interpretation of what is this nirvana experience or liberation experience, that might differ superficially. That need not take you to the conclusion that they are talking about different nirvanas or different liberations and so on. It is the same type of spiritual, you know, achievement which language is incapable of capturing, but that need not be taken as defect in language and I will improve that language. Not possible. It is not the possibility or capacity of language to capture this dimension of spiritual reality. The paper is open for me. Okay, sure.
Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Yadavji, for a very insightful presentation. Very nicely you have put how Zen Buddhism comes very close to Wittgenstein. This is a new attempt, I would say. And very rightly you have pointed how in Zen Buddhism there is a level of transcendence and which cannot be expressed by human language. And also you have shown how from the Tractatus how the distinction between saying and showing, and how showing could explain the nature of transcendence. Now, what I would like to place before you is that perhaps in the later part of later Wittgenstein, there are a broader scope for this. Like, for example, in this posthumous publication, LAPR, that is lectures on aesthetics, psychology, religious belief, and all that one, in that book. He very clearly says that when somebody says 2 plus 12 is equal to 13 instead of 14, he says, don't say that it is a logical blunder. A person who has common sense would say it is a logical blunder, but he says it is not a logical blunder. See how the person has used his own logic. This means that every language has its own game, and we can't extend this game further. In fact, he says, if somebody believes in a Christian believes in the day of judgment, for a non-believer, this is a meaningless statement. So I feel that there is a different ways of looking at the language, and very beautifully you have pointed out, and Sarah has also given a very nice comment on that, that how language, the same language, which could be seen from two different perspectives, because we don't have any other language. So perhaps we can call it mystical language or transcendent language, but that language is the only language, since it is available to us, we can make some effort to say something, though we have the limitation. So this approach is something very novel, and I would like to, of course this is my observation only, I would like to congratulate you for giving a new direction to Wittgenstein and Zinn.
Anyone else? So you want to reply?
Thank you, Professor Bhatt sir, Professor Sarvam sir, to add something very valuable and very important to my paper, which I will incorporate, and very rightly and very beautifully, in a correct reference, Professor Bhatt has commented and put the content which I have tried to put before you. So, and secondly, Professor Sarvam, that is something and indicated me to go to the literature of Wittgenstein, which are Cosmos, Philosophical Institutions, also Cosmos and other writings. I will certainly go towards those literatures to enrich my paper. And again, thank you to all of you for listening me recently and giving you suggestions. Thank you.